that.
No, it's so dirty, and it's... The maintenance guy sitting down there waiting for him. It just ain't the maintenance guy, it's that tide train.
Oh, it is?
Yeah. Yeah, he must be going down into the siding down here. It's certainly key to try to break that track record, but to your point a little bit earlier, I think we'll get the four lap record this year. Not a great first lap for Kevin Simpson in this qualifying sim, all the way down to 227.152. We now see his teammate, Alex Bloom, out on the speedway. Alex is about halfway down the back straightaway, and of course, was the pole sitter a year ago. As for Kevin Simpson, he's had that straightaway. What can he do on this next lap? It's a little bit faster, 229.102. So maybe that first lap of that qualifying sim had him a bit of a moment and has got it underneath him, and that's a little bit better for Kevin Simpson up to 229.102. As for Alex Bloom, his first lap, that's 219.
Still a long train.
Speed for Alex Bloom. So we're watching him, Michael, navigate this out. Speedway.
Yeah, this is one that very interested in as Alex Bloom makes his way down the back straightaway for the first time. This will be the first lap of the mock qualification run for the defending pole sitter and, of course, the NTT IndyCar Series champ, the reigning champ. He makes his way through the north end. Nice line. Right sides get right up against that outside retaining wall. The exits turn number four, a little less conservative, or I should say a little more conservative, about 3 foot off that line as he crosses for the very first time. And for Alex Bloom, 231.31.
Just about every color you can think of on that car. DHL Honda for Chip Ganassi Racing.
That's old.
Turn number two, Alex Bloom. This is a full-on qualifying sim. As I look, not seeing anybody in front of him on the back straightaway, so not pulling a toe at all. Again, 231.318. He'll shoot it into turn number three. I think he'll pull it to about 239 miles per hour with the telemetry that we are looking at. He's roaring out of turn number four, and he is indeed catching somebody, and he's going to get a toe off of, I believe, that's Agustin Canapino. So this lap, Michael, it's faster, 231.799.
Yeah, it is.
That qualifying set, which is so very important to guys like Barry Wanzer on that timing stand. They want to see a true qualifying run. And when we go qualifying yesterday, you're not going to see somebody pick up nearly 0.4 of a mile per hour.
So I'll just change gears from Alex Bloom. Santino Ferrucci at 232.3. And the last time by a 232.5 for Santino Ferrucci. I believe he's by himself. We were watching Alex Bloom, but I saw Ferrucci streak across the start-finish line. And that's a pretty big lap if that's indeed a non-toe lap.
I'm not seeing it show up on the no-toe report, Michael.
I don't ruin my